Safini, karibuni sana kwenye video yetu ya leo. Leo tutaendelea na operators in C program. Tutaangazia juu ya logical operators. Last video tulisoma juu ya arithmetic and relational operators in C program. Logical is about clear reasoning, yani kufikiria clearly is what we mean by logical. You check the facts, yani ile ukweli iko pale, ikiwa ni swali umepewa, unaangalia kama ni ukweli ama ni uongo, alafu unapeana nini? Majibu. Hiyo ndio inaitwa logical, logical thinking. You have to reason according to the rules that are there. Sasa pia katika computer we have logical operators whereby the program has to decide whether something is true or false. Katika program, tunakuanga na logical operators. Logical operators checks whether the conditions, it has different conditions, it checks whether it is true or false. Based on those conditions, it gives results. Yani inaangalia zile conditions zenye ziko. Ina decide, is that condition true or false? Then based on that condition, inapeana results. We said that operators are symbols. So they are symbols based on those symbols, the symbol that you are given. The conditions that are there, it will decide whether the conditions are true or false. Alafu itupatie nini? Majibu zetu. Ama majibu yenye inatakikana. Tuko na aina tofauti ya logical operators. Ya kwanza ni logical AND. It is represented by ampersand. Then we have logical OR, whereby we have two vertical bars. Then we have logical NOT, whereby it is explanational mark. So these are the names of the operators. These are the symbols that are there. So we start with the first one, logical AND operator. Indio simple yake. So both the condition must be true for the answer to be true. So unaangalia condition ya kwanza, umeenda ya pili. Alafu based on the conditions, kama the condition ya kwanza na ya pili, unapata results. So both the condition, they must be true for the answer to be true. So unaangalia first condition here is true, the next one is true, the answer is true. The next one is true, the other one is false, the answer is false. The other one is false, then true, then the answer is false. Then you have false and false, the answer is false. So the only time the condition, the answer is true, is when the two conditions are true. So both the condition must be true for the answer to be true. Kindly note that. We have an example here for logical AND. We have the first condition. We check 10 is 10 less than 5. This one is false because 10 is greater. So 10 is not less than 5. Then we have the next condition here. We have 20 is greater than 10. This condition is true because we know very well that 20 is greater than 10. So the first condition is false. The next condition is true. And we have said in logical AND, both conditions should be true for the answer to be true. So our answer here will be false. The next one is logical OR operator. So we said that that one will be represented by two vertical bars. So any or one of the conditions must be true for the answer to be true. Yani, hii condition ya kwanza inaweza kuwa true ama ya pili kuwa true. Any of the two conditions, ikuwa true ndio answer hapa itakuwa true. So moja, hii ikuwa ukweli na hii ikuwa ukweli, answer itakuwa ukweli. Hii ikuwa ukweli, hii ikuwa si ukweli, answer itakuwa ukweli. So any of the conditions should be true for the answer to be true. So the first condition here is true, the next one is true, the answer is true. This one is true, false, the answer is true. Then this one is false and false, the answer is false. So the only time the answer is false is both conditions are false. So if any of the condition has true in it, the answer is true. So we are going to look at an example, logical OR. So we have the same example here. 10 is less than 5. So this one is false. Then 20 is greater than 10. This one is true. So the first condition is false. The next condition is true. But in between we have logical OR. So logical OR says that any of the condition should be true for the answer to be true. So our answer here will be true. So tunaangalia, iya kwanza any of the condition inafaa kuwa true. kwa sababu hapa moja hapa ni true, ndio maana answer yetu ni true. So the next one is logical not. Sawa sawa. Hii una reverse the condition. Hapa kuna condition ya kwanza ni true, una reverse inakuwa false. Ya pili ni false, una reverse inakuwa true. Sasa hiyo ndio inaitwa logical not. Tutaangalia example. Katika example yetu ni the same example, but we have brackets, then outside the brackets ndio tumeweka logical not. So the first one, the first inside the brackets, we have 10 is less than 5, which is false. Then we have 20 is greater than 10. Then this one is true. So this one is false, this one is true. In between we have logical and. So with logical and, when one side is false, the other one is true, the answer is false. So the answer here is false, because the only time the logical end becomes true if both conditions are true. So this condition is false. When you add the logical not in the beginning of this condition inside the brackets, it will reverse the result. So results here is false, so it will reverse these results to be true. So we will go to code block. We look at these examples so that you can understand more about logical operators. Inside code block, we are going to start by declaring variables. Int a is equals to 10. B is equals to 10. Then we have C is equals to 20. Then we have capital R. Then we put semicolon. Here we have declared and initialized variable on the same line. Next, we are going to create a calculation. So R is equals to, we put brackets, A is equals to B. Then we put the and sign, that is the logical operator. Then inside the other condition, we put C is less than, C is less than B. Then at the end, you put a semicolon. Then here inside the results, you're going to change the output to semi percentage D. Then we put comma, then capital R. Then we copy these so that we cannot repeat writing the same thing. We will just change the sign. So here we will put logical or. Then here we will remove this one, we remove this one. Then we put the logical not. So we have the first one logical and logical, or the logical not. Yes. So we are going to save. Then we are going to build our program to see if there's any errors. We have zero errors, zero warning. That is very good. Then we run the program. Very good. So we have written the variables here. So because of these variables, we have R is equals to A is equals to B. So A is 10, B is 10. So this one, the 10 is equals to 10. That one is true. So in the next one, we have C is less than B. So C is 20. 20 is less than 10. This one is false. So when we have true and false, and here we have logical and, the answer is false. That's why we have 0, because we said 0 represents false, 1 represents true. The next one we have R is equals to A is equals to B. So 10 is equals to B. This one is true. Then C is less than B. So C is 20 is less than 10. This one is false. In between we have logical or. So with logical or, any of the conditions should be true for the answer to be true. So this one is true, so that is why the answer is true. The answer is 1. So this one here we should reverse, because we have logical not. A is equals to B. So this one is aside, A is 10, B is 10. So this one is true. So we reverse. We say that the answer will be false. So that is why we have the answer as 0. So make sure you write the code very well, and you make sure that everything, that there is no errors in the code before you run the program. So we have seen this program. The answer is 010. So make sure you get the same results as we have gotten. Asanteni sana kwa kunisikiza. Mkumbuke kusubscribe kwa hii channel na mlike hii video.